Today topic we are going to discuss about the column splice. So column splice, the definition for this one is it is a connecting two pieces of section to get the required length of the column is called as a column splicing. Okay, so that means when we connect the two pieces of section to get the required length, so that type of the column we call it as a column splicing. In multi-story building, most probably if you observe, the section of the column may be changed from one story to the another story for economy. So this also creates the need for the splicing. So in such cases, column is preferably spliced at point of inflection, which is usually 152 300 mm above the floor line. There are two distinct types of compression splices are there. For suppose those having ends are cut by the ordinary method, and the second one is those ends are milled. These are the two methods are there for the compression splices. For suppose if the ends are not milled, that means there is the ordinary method. The splice plates and their connections to the columns are designed to transmit the forces only. Whatever the, all the forces will transfer. For suppose if the columns are having milled ends, the ends are placed firmly in contact with each other, and hence considerable load is transferred by the bearing. So the connections and the spliceless plates are designed for only 50% of the axial load. This is the most important sentence. So the connections and the splice plates are designed for only 50% of the axial load. Okay. For suppose we have various types of the column splices are there. For suppose this is your column. Okay. Now I am connecting a splice, one more plate here. So like this, these are the bolts. So this one is when columns are same size, these are the same size. Sometimes the columns are like this. So if you observe here, so again here on plate, on column. So here the columns are slightly different sizes are there. And also the filler plates are used. This one filler plates are using. So load is transferred partially by bearing. Okay. And next columns are, you know, if you observe here, I will draw one more column. These are the bolted connections, whatever I am drawing now. Yeah. So if you observe this one, the columns are of considerably different size. So bearing plates are using. This is also a different size. So like this, we have column splices are there. And next, design of the column splices. There are some rules and are there for design of a column splices. The first thing is, when you are going to design the column splice, first of all, the column splice plates may be assumed to act as a short columns of zero senescence ratio. First of all, you have to assume like that. And you have to assume the FCD value is Fi by 1.1. And you have, based on this one, you have to calculate the required area. And also, width of the splice plate, the second point is, width of the splice plate, whatever we are taking. So this is equal to the flange of the column. So this is the most important rule, the second one. Whatever we are taking the width of the splice plate, we will take it as a flange of the column, okay? The third one is, whatever we will selected the diameter of the bolt, bolt value is computed, and also we have to calculate the number of required bolts. So once if we calculate it, we have to know the moment and the shear force are also acting in addition to the axial load. The splice plates are provided to the flanges as well as the web. Okay. And also when bearing plates are to be provided to join the two columns, for suppose when the two columns are there, if you want to join those things and also unequal sizes, we have to follow some design steps for design of the bearing plate. That is, the bearing plate may be assumed as a short beam to transmit the axle load to the lower column. Same like that, the axle load of the column, whatever it may be, load is acting on the column, you have to assume and also taken by the only flanges, okay? And the maximum moment of the plate, you have to take by P by 2 into A. And also, if you know the thickness of the bearing plate, you have to calculate thickness. There is a formula, that is 6M by BFBS. This is the formula to calculate the thickness of the bearing plate. And here the FBS is nothing but design bending stress, that is Fi by gamma M naught. Fi, we know most of the time we've taken for 410 grade steel, that is the 250. Gamma M naught is 1.1. So you will get 227.27 Newton per M, 27 Newton per mm square. So this is the rules while designing the splice, column splice. Now we will solve one problem. I will write the problem. A column section ISHB, Indian Standard Heavy Beam 300. The weight is 577 Newton per meter. Is carrying a factor load factored axle load of 600 kilonewton and also a factored moment of 30 kilonewton meter and a factored shear force of 60 kilonewton. Okay, now we have to design a suitable column splice. Assume ends are milled. Now, my dear students, if you observe this problem, a column section is given already, that is the ISHB 300, that is the Indian Standard Heavy Beam, is carrying a factored axle load is 600 kilonewton, as well as the factored moment is 30 kilonewton meter, and also the shear force is 60 kilonewton. So now we are going to design a suitable column splice, and the ends are milled. It's not ordinary method, the ends are milled. Now we will solve the solution for this one. The solution is, since the ends are milled, I told the condition is 50% of axle load transferred through bearing and splice plates transfer the remaining 50% of the load. Yeah, so if the ends are milled, you know, I told you the rule, that is a 50% of the axle load is transferred through the bearing, and also splice plates transferred through the remaining 50% of the axle load. So now the load to be transferred by splice plate is how much? Already the axle load is 600. So half means by 2. So you will get 300 kilonewtons. So now the load to be transferred by the splice plate is 300 kilonewton. Okay. So now the load to be transferred by each splice plate. So you know we have two splice plates are there. So again 300 by 2 I will write here. The load to be transferred by each splice plate equal to 300 by 2, you will get 150 kilonewton. So on both sides of the columns where we are providing the splice plates, this load, the total load 300 kilonewton will distributed equally on each splice plate. Okay, that's why we will get 150 kilonewton. Okay, now assuming the thickness of the plate or splice plate that is 6 mm. So now calculate the lever arm. A is the lever arm. So that is nothing but 300 is the distance, ISHB member, that is the 300 mm, the section 300 plus a 6. So you will get 306 mm. Okay. So now the force in each plate due to movement, we have to calculate force in each plate due to movement. That is, we will get movement by the lever arm. Movement is, we know, 30 into 10 cube by lever arm is A, 306. So you will get 98.04 kilonewtons. This is the force in each plate due to movement. So now we have to calculate the total load in each splice plate. That means we have to calculate each plate is 150 plus 98.04. Okay, I will write here. Total load in each splice plate is 150 plus 98.04. You will get 248.04 kilonewton. Okay, this is the total load. So now the next step is, we know already for the rolled sections, the Fi value is 250 newton per mm square. Okay. This is for the rolled section. So area required, how we will calculate the area? So we know already the load, just now we calculated, that is a PD 248 into 04. And FCD value is the FCD, we know already Fi by 1.1. So area is, I will write again here, PD by FCD. So PD is nothing but load, this is a 248.04. And FCD is, for these splices, we will take Fi by 1.1. Fi is 250 by 1.1. So you will get the answer is 1091.376 mm square. Okay, this is the area required. Now, the next condition I told you, you have to take the width of the splice plate is equal to the width of the flange. So width of the flange, I will write here. Width of splice plate equal to width of flange. So the width of the flange from the ISHB 300, for that one, if you take the steel table, you will get 250 mm. That is a TF. So it is nothing but width of the splice plate. Now the thickness is required. How we will calculate the required thickness? That is nothing but whatever we got the area here, you see, area by width of the splice plate. I will write here, area is 1091.376 by 250. I will get 4.365 mm. So this is the thickness. So let us provide 6 mm plates. The higher one is above 4.75 is 6 mm only. That's why we are providing 6 mm plates. So now we have to design the bolts for these splices. Okay. Now I will take, let us take, use 20 mm bolts of grade 4.6. Okay. Now for this one, you have to calculate the strength of each bolt. So that bolt, you have to calculate in the two methods, in strength in single shear and strength in bearing. So from that, whichever is the least value, you have to take that. So first I will calculate strength in single shear. We know formula is Fu by root 3 gamma m 0.78 into 5 by 4 d square. This we are doing so many times in the previous lectures. So Fu is, we know, I substitute here 400 by root 3 into 1.25 into 0.78 into 5 by 4 into 20 square, that is a d square. So this is the strength in shear value. You will get 45,272 newtons. This is the strength in single shear. Same like that, how to calculate the strength in bearing? Okay, I will write here. Yeah, we know already for the formula of strength in bearing is 2.5 into kb dt dw, like that. There is a formula is there, but here is it always is getting the much higher value. Okay, it is much higher. So if more than minimum specified edge distance is provided, that's why the minimum value directly we are taking the bolt value equal to 45,272 newtons. Okay, now from this value we have to calculate the number of bolts required. I will write here number of bolts required equal to, so we know already total load in each splice, that is 248.04. It is in kilonewtons. So if I convert into the newtons, multiply with 10,000 or 10 cube by bolt value, that is bolt value is 45,272. So you will get 5.47. Okay. So that means we have to provide the total 6 bolts. So that means provide 3 bolts on each side of the web, whatever we are taking. Okay. For suppose if the section is like this. So for this time we will provide 3, this side we will provide the 3 bolts. Now write like that, provide 3 bolts on each side. Each side of the web, okay. The next step is to resist the shear, the splice plates are provided on each side of the web, okay. And also the maximum shear force, they given is 60 kilonewtons. Now we have to calculate the yield strength of the web. Why? Because to resist the shear, the splice plates we are providing on the web only. That's why we have to calculate the yield strength of the web. The formula is Fyw by root 3. This is available in the clause number 8.4.1 in IS 800-2007 code book. So please look into this one, yield strength of the web. So FIE, we know that is a 250 by root 3. You will get 144.3 newton per mm square. So now this is the yield strength of the web. So from this, we have to calculate the area of the plates required. So how you will calculate the area of plates required? That means 60 into 10 cube, that is the shear force, by yield strength, that is the 144.3. You will get 416 mm square. This is the area of the plates required. So now the area, this plate is on the two sides only. So if you want to know area of the each plate, that is 416 by 2. So I will write that one, area of each plate equal to 208 mm square, that is 41 by 2. We are distributing this area on the two sides. Okay. Now use 6 mm plates. We know already we do that one. So now number of bolts required. How we will calculate the number of bolts required? That is the shear force is 60 into 10 cube by the bolt value. So for this case, you will get 1.33. So that's why now provide the 2 bolts here. And also using 6 mm web splice, the arrangements, whatever the arrangements, now I will draw one section of this one. The splice, that is this one, the column, Yeah. Our IS MVP. Okay. The 6 mm plate, whatever we are taking here. Again, 6 mm plate for the column, attaching. Bolts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Same like that here also. Okay. Here if you observe, these are the bolts. You see the section. So this is a 150 mm. And this plate is a 6 mm plate. And this is also 6 mm plate. And this bolt, whatever we are using, that is a 20 mm bolt. Okay, the gauge distance here, that is the edge distance 35. And the pitch is a 50. Okay, here also edge distance is 35. And the distance is around 80. Okay, like this, you have to calculate and how to draw the splice. This is the design of the splice problem. So I will stop.